Here I will be demonstrating how to integrate with the USPS Address Information API, which will allow you to validate that an address that you have in your FileMaker database is in fact correct. So first thing that you'll need to do is navigate on over here to this web page where you can register. And once you register, USPS will send you an email with your user ID and password. The user ID is what you'll be using to make requests to USPS in order to get the correct address. And what you'll need to do is build a URL that looks similar to this, where these X's are actually your user ID that you have been provided, and this address information in here is the address that you're trying to check. You also want to make sure that this is all URL encoded using the FileMaker function get as URL encoded, so that way it'll work flawlessly. So in here I have an example where I have the address information entered in here, and what this validate address button does is it has a script which will create a URL and then pass that on over to the API, which will then return an XML. So I'll click it, and what it does is it checks what USPS passes to what I have. And if everything matches, that means everything's good and it's great. So if I click OK, we'll see here, this is the XML response. And you see that, you know, there's capitalization difference, but it's the same. The numbers and everything are great. So that means this is correct. So if I go to the next record, where I have Reed Street spelled R-E-A-D, and I validate, it does the same. It says that it's not correct, because what I'm doing in the script in the background is I'm just checking each line to see if they match, and they don't, because it's R-E-E-D Street, or Road. So, in here, it's not going to give you that there's an error. It's just going to give you the correct one. The only time it'll give you an error is if there's any connection issues, or where it can't find any kind of address at all. So if I click to validate here, this is the error provided. But if we look at the actual XML, there's this error tag, the number, and basically giving you the address right here saying the address has not been found. The only other kind of error that can be helpful to you in this integration is if there's an address that has multiple. So say it's an apartment complex that should have an apartment or a suite number, and you don't have that provided, the API will actually let you know that there should be something. So this is the error message in the XML, but if we look at the XML itself, you'll see there's a return text, and so that's what they're saying here, is that the address you provide is correct, however, you're still missing a little more information. So that's the only thing that I took out was that suite number. If you do run into any kind of issues, you'll want to make sure that you check out this number right here. You might need to give them a call to have them activate your code. I didn't have to do it. It worked when I did it, but other times I've had people who said that they needed to call it. So if you're not able to integrate with them, you're getting error messages back, you may need to call and get your user ID activated. Feel free to look at the article if you need more fuller explanations, or you can even download this example file from our website. Thank you.